All right, then. Mr. Cologne, you may call your first witness.
Dr. Diposo, would you please tell the jury what it is you do for a living?
I'm what they call a forensic psychiatrist. I deal primarily in the assessment and treatment of people in prisons, people in psychiatric hospitals, and occasionally individuals among the general public who have mental health issues.
And are you familiar with Holly Kerrigan?
Yes, I am. In fact, I met with her personally this morning. In addition, I've studied the records of the crime of which she's accused. Transcripts, police reports, evidence files.
And have you come to any opinion regarding Ms. Kerrigan's mental health in the hours, days, or even weeks surrounding the killing?
I have. Based on everything that I've reviewed, it seems fairly obvious to me that prior to the killing, she was suffering from a profound case of PTSD, stemming from both her relationship with Mr. Navarre and its aftermath, and in the days and weeks leading up to and including the killing. I believe her behavior fits the legal definition of insanity.
Right? You hear about PTSD all the time. Seems like it's everywhere. Is it even real? Does such a thing actually exist?
Oh, it absolutely exists. In fact, it's been recognized for over a century under different names. In World War I, they called it shell shock. In World War II, they referred to it as battle fatigue. It's all the same thing. And it doesn't just happen to soldiers in combat. Anyone who's party to or witnesses a traumatic event is a candidate for it.
And does PTSD make you insane?
No, it does not.
And yet you began your testimony by stating unequivocally that Holly Kerrigan was legally insane. Or at least she was in the days or hours prior to Roger Navarre's death.
I do. I think a simple review of the facts makes that abundantly clear.
How do you mean?
Put aside whether you believe the act of murder is the undertaking of a sane person. Making a choice to kill a person in front of so many witnesses is not. Add to that, that once she pulled the trigger, she made absolutely no attempt to flee. Add to that, then she tried to kill herself. That human being, in that moment, is not sane.
I see. Thank you very much. I have no further questions, Your Honor.
Dr. Diposo, you testified that you met with the accused for the first time this morning.
That's correct.
And what time did that meeting take place?
We started at around 10 a.m.
And how long did you go?
A little over 2 hours.
Okay, so it's a little after 2 now, 45 minutes for lunch. Wouldn't you say that you arrived at your conclusions rather quickly?
Again, the accused's behavior in that moment says it all. No matter how much time I might have to contemplate, it wouldn't change my conclusions.
John Wilkes Booth. Insane?
Excuse me?
John Wilkes Booth, the man who shot Abraham Lincoln, did it in a theater full of people. By your definition, wouldn't he be insane?
I'm not prepared to render a decision on that. I've never met with Mr. Booth.
Of course not. And he did try to flee, so never mind.
Objection, Your Honor. Counsel is badgering the witness.
My apologies, Your Honor. I'll withdraw the question, Your Honor. How about Sirhan Sirhan? Shot Bobby Kennedy in a room full of people in a hotel in Los Angeles. Insane?